11 days after the brutal shooting to death of the former State Minister of Labor, Charles Okello Engola Machodugo. His body has finally been laid to rest here in Awang Village in Oyam District.
The day started with prayers led by the Church of Uganda Diocese of Lango and Northern Uganda, with the retired Bishop Onono Nelson Onweng calling for stronger church values within the armed forces.
And reconsider restoring religious service in the armed forces. I'm appealing to the proprietors of private security arms to establish chaplaincy, religious chaplaincy in their institutions.
Thousands of people came to pay their last respect to the late Colonel Charles Okello Engola Machodugo at his ancestral home in Awangi, Oyam District. The preacher of the day, Professor Bishop Alfred Olua, relayed a condolence message on behalf of the people of Northern Uganda. Above all, he prayed for hope in the bereaved family, especially for the widow, Joyce Aikuru, who was set to wed her beloved husband in 2 weeks' time, and also to his 5 children.
God, why? Don't open your damn bar. God, why have you punished us like this? Our God knows it well. His justice will prevail.
The bishop of the Diocese of Lango also prayed for reconciliation and forgiveness, while the local leaders and residents of Oyam are requesting the government to find ways of putting an end to gun-related death.
We are really very disappointed, very annoyed, disheartened, and the government really must come out and do something about these incidences of how people are using the guns very recklessly.
To try to copy and paste whatever Colonel Machodugo was doing, he was a tough man in some aspects, but he was also a very lovely man. As I worked with him, I had to learn a lot from him.
Lieutenant General Kayanja Muhanga spoke on behalf of the UPDF, commending the efforts of Charles Engola as an army officer. As the different dignitaries elogized and laid wreath on the casket of Charles Engola, the head of the Otikokin clan, Sam Engola, who is also the immediate elder brother of the late, extended his appreciation to President Yoweri Museveni for the support rendered to the family.
I cried. The president called me. I told people in Korolo, and I'm telling you here, I could not know what to say, even to talk, what I talked to him, I can't remember. Because I was over crying, I just shouted, I said, Your Excellency, my brother is dead here, I am crying, my head is not working, I cannot talk.
While the Lango Parliamentary Chief Whip presented Engola Jr. as their preferred choice to replace his father in Parliament.
Then I will present Mr. Engola Jr. to you. Loa Kloya Jr.
Charles Okello Engola Machodugo was shot dead on the morning of the 2nd of April 2023 by his guard, Private Wilson Sabiti, at his home in the Kampala suburb of Chanja.
The Vice President Jessica Alupo has delivered President Yoweri Museveni's message, describing Machodugo as a lion who contributed to the prevailing peace here in Northern Uganda.
Her Excellency Jessica Alupo read a letter from the president. The president also extended a helping hand of 20 million shillings to the widow.
The Republic of Uganda, and on my own behalf, I convey my heartfelt condolences to the wife, the children, the entire family, the government, and all Ugandans for this big loss. Colonel retired Charles Engola Okello was a lion.
The casket containing the remains of the late State Minister of Labor Charles Okello Engola Machodugo was lowered to the ground at around 3:45 p.m. and given a 11-gun salute. Thank you. Among other requests that the people of Lango have extended to the government are an expeditious investigation as to why Charles Sengola was shot 28 times, leading to his death. They also want the former state minister of labor to be given a rise in the rank to a brigadier general and construct a general hospital, tarmac the Bobby to Icheme Road and rename it to Macho Duogo Road. I am Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news in Oyam District.